greatest thrill is its abundant wildlife. Few places of the world offer such a collection of wild animals roaming everywhere you go. Mountain goats are so common, cars often have trouble getting through on the roads. Deer and elk will graze right down to the edge of the camps. And the bighorn sheep are so tame that you can get remarkably close. Jasper National Park is a wildlife photographer's dream. Even the bears seem unaffected by people. These scenes were taken right alongside the Icefields Parkway with the cars buzzing by. Wildlife abounds in this region of beautiful lakes and snow-capped peaks, but the region's most popular attractions are the massive glaciers that spill out of the Columbia ice fields and down the mountainsides. The Brewster brothers, who hold almost legendary status in these parts, built this chalet to house visitors to the Athabascan Glacier. The Brewsters developed a bus on big tires they called a snow coach. The first ones were fairly primitive, but over the years they have grown into these Star War-like vehicles that move people over the glacier for an adventure on the ice. This is a bumpy ride. The coach is moving along at about 4 miles an hour, and in spite of the tire size, the rocking is pretty severe. Each spring, a new snow trail has to be created. This is not a permanent road. It is always melting, freezing, snowing, and melting again. This is not a stable trail, though the ice is actually several hundred feet thick. At the end of the snowy road, the passengers disembark and walk out onto the ice. This was the first glacier walk attraction up North America. Since it began, thousands of people have had the experience of wandering out over the Athabascan Glacier that spills out of the massive Columbia ice field high overhead. From the Athabascan Glacier, we continue south and soon pass from Jasper into Banff National Park. The Icefields Parkway connects the Columbia ice fields with Lake Louise and Banff to the south. At times, the scale of the scenery, the size of the mountains, the height of the waterfalls, and the thickness of the ice cause us to overlook nature's more delicate sights. Lovely wildflowers bloom from spring to autumn, covering the fields and valley floors. At the southern end of the parkway, we arrive at two of Canada's best-known destinations, Lake Louise and Banff. The tracks of the Canadian Pacific pass through these resorts, and for 34 years, the Canadian took the southern route, stopping in Banff and Lake Louise rather than Jasper to the north. Lake Louise is one of the most picturesque spots on Earth. It stands in front of towering mountains, glaciers pouring off the slopes. The spot is almost mystical at times. On the shores of the lake stand the world-famous Chateau Lake Louise. Like the Jasper Park Lodge, its origins were humble, initially a small cabin for passengers off of the train. But the railroad saw the potential of this spot and erected a hotel on the site worthy as a travel destination unto itself. Giant yellow poppies surround the hotel and grow wild in the nearby fields. The Canadian Pacific Railroad built and continues to operate this hotel. At one end of the lobby is one of the most glorious picture windows of the world, framing a true postcard view. The feeling inside is that of a Bavarian chalet. The atmosphere is old world, friendly and warm, a carry back to another time, when travel was less rushed and people traveling through Canada on the Canadian could stop and spend a few days. Nearby to Lake Louise is Moraine Lake. This is often called the most photographed lake in the world. Millions of cameras have been aimed at this spot.